all the way.
Mmm.
Wow.
Wow.
It's so much sesame.
It's so much sesame. Mmm.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Basically the best recipe we ever ran.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
This is it.
This is it. So good.
Power.
Power move. And it's so much salt.
Yeah. And so much garlic.
Truly.
Oh.
All right. Another bite. Another wrap for me. Mmm. Mmm. Wow. All right, so sometimes, I know a lot of people think I have a dream job, but sometimes at your dream job, you get to report your dream story. And July of 2014 was one of those times when I pitched and then got assigned a story about Korean grilling, which is some of my favorite food to eat. The recipe I'm doing today is a gochujang marinated pork shoulder steak that I learned from Rachel Yang, who's a chef in Seattle. And when I met her, she totally blew my mind, because until that moment, I did not know that pork shoulder, which I always thought was a cut that you had to braise or slow roast or cook for a really long amount of time, could be marinated and grilled very, very quickly and served kind of juicy and pink inside. So the first thing you have to do is not buy a pork chop. Pork chops are cut from the loin with the rib, and they're really, really lean. I've said it before and I'll say it again, fat is flavor. So what you need to do is go talk to your butcher for a minute and ask him or her to cut you some 1-inch thick boneless pork shoulder steaks. And you can tell just by looking at these cuts how incredibly well marbled they are. So get behind the pork shoulder steak and then get behind this Korean marinade. It's like all of the things, right? You can have sweetness. There's sweetness in the mirin and in the sake in this, but there's also these like very pungent, strong flavors from the garlic and from the gochujang, which is a fermented red pepper paste. It's hot, but it's tangy and it's pungent. Oil, that's vegetable oil. This fresh ginger, heat, spicy, but also, peppery ginger. It's so fresh. It's so zingy. That's mirin. It's got a lot of sweetness. It's got a little bit of tanginess. And this is sake. And if you don't have sake or are cooking with it, honestly, I would just use water. It won't have the sweetness. One of the things I learned from her was that the more flavorful and pungent and concentrated the marinade itself is, the shorter amount of time you actually need to marinate the meat. I hit the on-off button at the same... All right. The other thing with this marinade is to reserve... I'm just going to use one of the ones I used. A quarter cup. And that's going to be for basting. It's just keeping some of the marinade separate so that it doesn't have like the meat juices all over it. And that way you can baste throughout. All right, so now this pork with my marinade already set aside is going right in here. I'm turning to cover. I just looked at the original recipe and it said to chill it while it marinates for 2 hours. Thinking about that now, 5 years later, I would leave it at room temperature for those 2 hours. There's so much going on here. I don't think there's any problem with doing that. And I think you could marinate it even longer if you wanted to. If you want to go past 2 hours, pop it in the fridge. But of course, because we're in the magical Bon Appetit Test Kitchen, I have one that's already marinated. Ta-da! All right, we're going to take this over to the grill and hit it with some hot, hot heat. Two things to keep into consideration. It's loud over there, but I'll be yelling about this when we're there. There's a good amount of sugar in this marinade. There's sugar in the gochujang. There's sugar in the sake. There's sugar in the mirin. There's sugar in the ginger, frankly. So your risk of burning exists, and it may be a little bit more pronounced than usual. I want to use that to my advantage because I really do want that charring and that nice flavor. Just think about that while we're over yonder. And then straight out of the marinade. you're going to get some flare-ups. You're going to get flare-ups because as the fat renders and it hits the flame, it makes fire. That's your flare-up. So my rule of thumb is to turn fattier cuts like this, and this is true whether you're cooking a beef steak or a pork steak, to cook it, turn it frequently regardless, but definitely turn it anytime you see a flare-up. So I just saw a little flare-up happening right there. That's a great sign. It means the fat is starting to melt. It's hitting the fire below. It's flaring up. And if I'm going to take my own advice, I will be turning now. And then once I've got it on the second side, also embrace the char. Don't be alarmed by that dark color. I can go ahead and throw a little bit more marinade on the side that had been closest to the grill. So this should take about 8 minutes. This is an easy one to scale up too. I think that there was enough marinade there that if you wanted to use twice as much meat, you would have plenty of marinade to go around. These are starting to look really good. I'm into kind of a more even distribution of the charring. And I'm almost at the bottom of the amount of marinade that was set aside. This looks like that I've got a lot of nice charred spots, but the parts that aren't charred are like really nicely browned. Give this guy a little pressy press. Mmm, delicious. So it's springing back. It's not well done because it's still got some like bounce to it. A well done steak will just, you'll press it and it'll just be cardboard pushing back at you. But those took just about 8 minutes, which is exactly how long the recipe said they were gonna take. And now they do need to rest, which will give us time to get a couple sauces ready. With bread or no bread? No bread. No, God, no. Oh my God. Oh my God, I can't.
I need a bowl of pasta today.
It's island season. So while this is resting, I'm gonna get a sauce ready. The sauce is from another chef who I got to meet on this trip. This was the heyday. I went to Seattle to cook with Rachel, and then I flew to Chicago and I cooked with Ed Kim from Mott Street, and he showed me this Som sauce. And it has four ingredients, one of which is gochujang, and the other one is doenjang, which is made from miso. So it's a fermented soybean paste. And then to go into that, I have a good old jalapeno. I'm gonna finely chop. It's like, yes, there's spiciness, but there's also a good amount of sugar. I mean, back in the day, I was like, wow, I got on a plane, I was gone for a week. I went to 5 cities, didn't have to deal with this brouhaha. This is why I love to cook and why I love cooking and why I love being able to talk to chefs. The amount of information that other people have given me that have made me a better cook and a more informed human, I didn't get that from books. I got that from going to talk to people. It's like the freaking greatest thing in the world. All right, shallot, jalapeno, gochujang. All right, so this sauce will get a little bit better as it sits. The cue that Chef Ed gave me when I was with him was kind of like the consistency of blue cheese dressing, and I just feel like this is a little bit tight. Very delicious. A little dab will do ya. That looks great to me. Okay, done.
And that's when we rolled the sticker that says party time.
Party time. All right, now this is obviously the best part of the whole thing, which is when you get to make your Som wrapper. You could just eat the pork steak, that's totally fine, but my favorite part of Korean grilling and eating Korean grilled food is all of the other stuff that goes with it. So we're gonna make a little wrapper. One of the people that I interviewed, and I can't remember who it was now, so I can't quote him or her, but said that one of the best things that can happen to you in your life is that someone else will make a Som for you, and it will be like that perfect bite that they actually didn't make for themselves, but made for you. And since I have to go to a meeting. That might end up being what actually happens here. I'm trying to find the grain, but I'm not going to be crazy about it. Just thin slices, since you're not using a fork and knife in this. Yum. Oh my God, I love pork shoulder so much. Okay, a little bit of somme sauce. A little garlic. This is Rachel's somme. It's like she's making it for me. A little jalapeno. I'm gonna just add one other thing, which is sesame oil that has salt and pepper mixed into it, just a little bit. And I was so concerned with like what's allowed, what you should put in, what you can't put in, but really this should just be delicious to you. I feel like I'm supposed to give this to someone now that I said the perfect psalm is one you make for
Chris, Christina,
but I'm not
Molly, Jesse. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Or yourself.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You taste this. This is just the best thing you've ever had today. You're not a raw garlic person, though, really.
Kind of, yeah.
Really?
But this?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, right?
Other flavors to...
Sure, I didn't... I took it, it was in, it was out, it was in, then I took it back out again. Mm. I don't want to turn your stomach, you know what I mean? That's the perilla.
Oh. Will you make me another one right now?
Yeah.
Before you make one for anybody else?
How was the amount of pork in that? It was good, right? Not too much. You don't have to take one bite, but you're not making a burrito. That was another thing.
That has been
so good.
This is not an act.
You know, I have to go to a meeting, literally. This is so upsetting. I'm glad I had those two special bites and a very special moment with Chris Morocco. Jesse, so here's the thing.
Hello.
I have to go to a meeting.
Hi.
Hi.
All right, I didn't want to miss that. I was here. You guys were going to ravage it before I got here.
No, we were waiting for you to cut up the meat.
Joining.
Oh my God, join us.
Welcome.
It's a party.
So the big lettuce leaf, and then this guy, that's
raw garlic or the...
Sorry, Carla, we're out of time.